Now see, we spoke about infrastructure. What does it comprises of? Now I told you social infrastructure would comprise of your healthcare and other facilities. Similarly, your communication ports, etc., would comprise of economic infrastructure. Now, why infrastructure is so relevant? Let's understand that. See, when it comes to the understanding the relevance, it will facilitate modern agriculture. Modern agriculture requires irrigation facilities, it requires many other services, and which will be possible only because of having a strong infrastructure in the country. For example, speedy delivery is possible if you have proper connectivity between the cities, between the villages. As such, if you have proper banking, and I'm talking about proper penetration of the banks in the remotest area of the country, and if you have proper insurance facilities, then only the modern agriculture will be able to grow. Now you would have heard about the thing where this particular scheme which has been introduced by the government recently about insuring the crop. So all the farmers, there's an advertisement which keeps on coming on the TV wherein the farmers are asked to go ahead and get their crops insured. Okay, so in case if there is any kind of mishap, they can get the money from the insurance company. So government has come up with a scheme, and this has been possible only because of development of the infrastructure to that extent. Now it helps in increasing the productivity of factors of production. Because of the infrastructure, we are able to improve the factors of production, increase their productivity. As such, it improves the quality of life of people. Now just imagine, today someone in Assam can easily shift to a city like Bangalore for work. Similarly, someone from Bombay, if they want to, they can travel for their business purposes on a frequent basis to outside countries like US, UK, right? So all this is possible because the country has those infrastructure in place. Now it has resulted in reduction in the morbidity rate, that is, people now fall ill on a less basis, that is, there is a reduction in the number of people falling ill on a regular basis. Again, we have been able to provide a health system which is giving them a better facilities, health facilities, so that their survival rate, as you would have seen in economics when we were earlier, when we were discussing this, that the mortality rate has gone up. Now a person on an average lives up to 67 years old in India. So now what has happened is, even people fall ill on a lesser basis, and again the life of the person has increased. Now it has faster access to healthcare facilities. See, it's so common now, someone in a remote village, if he or she falls ill, because of the infrastructure, they can transfer the patient to a better hospital in the city. So all this happens because of the healthcare systems which are there and which are developing. See, when I'm talking about the relevance of infrastructure, remember the most important points. First, your agriculture sector and the industrial sector need it badly, be it banking, be it social systems, be it your insurance or even your roads, railways, dams, etc. Then the productivity of the factors of production keeps on increasing and improving. Now because of free mobility, or let's say increased mobility of people across the country, the trade increases. Okay, as such, again the agriculture and industry gets impacted and they also increase. So these are the points which needs to be remembered when you're talking about the relevance of infrastructure.